Good evening. In our previous session, we have seen the introduction to C programming language, and we covered the topic like variable, constant, keywords, data types in C programming language, then rules for naming a variable, and we have seen how to declare a variable. Now, the next topic for today is identifiers in any programming language. What do you mean by identifier in a program? Identifiers are the word which are not known to the compiler, right? So we have seen keywords. Keywords are known to the compiler. Meanings of the keywords are known to the compiler, but identifiers are the word. These are user-defined words or symbols in a program. It may be a variable name, constant name, function name, array name, structure name, union name, etc. It may be any name, user-defined name given to a variable, constant, function, array, structure or union. For example, if you write a line like this in a C program, int a comma b semicolon, it indicates the compiler that int is the keyword, right? A and b are variable, user-defined variable names. So we have given name to the variable a and b. It is user-defined name. So we can say that A and B are the identifiers in this line. So all the user defined names are nothing but the identifiers in a program. Now we'll see the next topic, that is operators, operand and expression. So whenever we write a mathematical expression, there are two important things, that is we use operators and we use operands to form a expression. Now what do you mean by an operator? It is the operation. Operator is nothing but it is going to perform the operation on operands. It is the operation to be performed on operands. Now, what do you mean by operands in a program? These are the variables on which the operation is going to be performed. Or we can say these are the variables on which the operator works. Now, what do you mean by an expression in a program? It is the combination of operands and operators. For example, if you see here a line is written like C equal to A plus B semicolon. So, this is one type of expression, mathematical expression. Here in this expression A and B are operands, whereas plus is the operator. In any expression, the compiler executes the evaluate the right hand side, and whatever may be the result of the right hand side is later on assigned to variable C. It means that in this expression A plus B will be solved first, and whatever may be the result is there of the expression gets stored into variable C later on. Now there are different types of operators we have in a programming language. Any programming language. So we have arithmetic operators. What are different arithmetic operators? All the arithmetic operators are like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and percentage symbol indicates a modulus operator. We know all these basic operators, plus, minus, multiplication and division, and the working of it also. So there is one new operator available here, that is percentage. Percentage is nothing but modulus operator, which gives you remainder after division. The plus operator is used to perform addition of two numbers. Minus operator is used to perform difference of two operands. Then next is multiplication, is basically used to multiply two operands. This divides two operands, and modulus perform the remainder after division. So the division operator gives quotient as a result, whereas modulus operator gives you remainder after division. There are certain rules in arithmetics in a C program, rules of arithmetics in C. So you have to remember three basic rules of arithmetics in C programming language. The operation between two integers results in integer. For example, if I add two integer values like 2 plus 3, the result would be 5. It means the operation between two integer value results in integer. Now the second rule says that the operation between two float or real numbers result in float in a real number, right? So for example, if I want to divide 5.0 divided by 2.0, the result would be 2.5. So the operation between two floats results in float. The third rule says that the operation between one integer variable and another float variable results in float. So the examples are given here. If you see this third example given here, that is 3.5 divided by 5. 3.5 is a float number, whereas 5 is integer number. If I try to perform this operation in C program, I will get 0.7 as the result. It means that the operation between one integer and another float variable results in float. The operation between two integers results in integer. If you see in the first example, 3 divided by 5, the result would be 0. It is not 0 point something, right? In a C program, the result of this expression would be 0. The operation between two real numbers results in a real number. Okay, 3.5 divided by 5.5 is equals to 0.63 in the C program, correct? Now we'll see modulus operator, the working of the modulus operator. Modulus operator basically used to find the remainder after division. Now consider the first example, 3 mod 5. If I read this expression, it is like 3 mod 5. What would be the answer of this modulus operator? The answer is 3, because 3 is not divisible by 5, the quotient becomes 0 and 3 is coming into the remainder. That's why the result is 3. 5 mod 5. 5 is completely divisible by 5. That's why the remainder is 0. 11 mod 5. Quotient in this division operation, quotient becomes 2 and the remainder is 1. So the output of this expression is 1 here. So these are all the arithmetic operators in a C program. The another operator is increment operator, and we're going to see what is the use of increment operator in a C program. Increment operator is basically represented by double plus sign, plus plus. Okay, it basically used to increment the value of the operand by 1. Now consider this example. Here the value of integer variable a is 5. If I write plus plus a semicolon, the result of this expression would be 6. It increments the value of variable a simply by 1. The another expression is, in another line, is a plus plus semicolon. Here also it increments the value of variable a by 1. In both the expression, please note that here it simply increments the value of the variable by 1. But the plus plus a is called pre-increment operator, whereas a plus plus is called as post-increment operator. Because in pre-increment operator, operator comes first before the operand. In post-increment, operator comes after the operand. There is definitely a difference between pre-increment and post-increment operator if it is used in assignment statement. But if you see both the lines, there is no assignment statement here, correct? So if it is used simply like this, there is no difference between pre-increment and post-increment in the expressions, right? But remember one thing, that there is definitely a difference between pre-increment and post-increment operator if it is used in assignment statement. We'll see that later on after finding the output of this code. Now check, in this code, integer a equal to 5, the result of plus plus a would be 6, and the next line a plus plus, it becomes 7. It increments 1 into the variable current value of a. The current value of a was 6 before this line, correct? So in this line, a value becomes 7. Now we'll see the effect of pre-increment and post-increment operator if it is used in assignment statement. Now what do you mean by pre-increment operator? This operator, if it is used in assignment statement, it first increments the value of the operand by 1, and it used that value for further calculation and finally assigned the result to LHS site. Consider the small code given here. Integer value of variable is 5 here, and there is another variable declared is b of integer type. See the expression written here, b equal to plus plus a plus 2 semicolon. It means that this is a pre-increment operator, because the operator is coming before the operand. Pre-increment, it means you have to immediately increment the value of variable a by 1 here. So the variable value a becomes 6 in this expression. 6 plus 2 is 8, and that value is now assigned to variable b. Last calculated value is assigned to variable b. At the end of this expression, a value becomes 6 because it is incremented here one time, and b value becomes 8. If you try to print the values of variable a and b using the printf statement like this in a C program, you will find the output on the screen, that is a equal to 6 and b equal to 8. Now we'll see the use of the postfix operation in the C program. If the postfix operator is used in any expression assignment statement, it takes the original value of the operand for calculation and assigns the result to the LHS. After final assignment to the LHS side, it finally increments the value of its operand by 1. So, if you see this code here again, there is a slight difference between a code. Here we used post increment operator. Integer a value is 5 here, b is declared as integer, b equal to 2 plus a plus plus. If you write like this operator in an expression, this is called as postfix operator, correct? Because plus plus is coming after variable a. In this calculation of the expression, it takes the value of variable value a as 5 and it adds that value with the 2. It becomes 7 and that value goes stored into variable b. So at the end of this expression, you will find variable value a becomes 6 because it incremented by 1 and b value becomes 7. It means that in this calculation, it takes the original value of the variable for calculating the LHS side, and then the result will be assigned to variable b, and at last it increments the value of variable a by 1. That's why it is called as post increment. Do everything and at last you increment the value of the variable by 1. If you try to print the value of the variable a and b by using the printf statement like this in a C program, you will find on the screen the output of variable a is 6 and variable b is 7. Okay, so till this point, if you have any point in today's session, you can ask me by raising your hand or by typing your question into the chat room. Any doubts? Okay. If there are no doubts, we will stop our session here. Thank you for watching the video.